Cybermen. It's a Cyberman story. Welcome to the Time Treadmill. I'm Ron, and these are my sweaty thoughts about Doctor Who. The Invasion is an 8-episode story, of which episodes 1 and 4 remain missing from the BBC archives. Those two episodes were restored back in 2006 for the 40th anniversary of this story. And of course, the big reveal comes at the very end of the 4th episode that this is, in fact, a Cyberman story. But long before we get to that point, I want to discuss the other major influence on this story and the purpose behind it. The Invasion is very clearly and very heavily influenced by the James Bond films of the 1960s, the Sean Connery films that were hugely popular at the time. And so the first half of this story could just as easily have been a James Bond story. You could replace the Doctor with Sean Connery and have virtually an identical story. Set in a near future London, the story involves a multinational corporation called International Electromatics, led by a man who comes straight out of the Bond villain playbook. I mean, take a look at this guy. Tobias Vaughn could just as easily be Ernst Blofeld. The short white hair, the permanent scowl, the ever-present arched eyebrow, this is just a classic international espionage villain right here. And the interesting thing, beyond those very clear influences, was that this story was also a trial balloon for a proposed new format to the series. You see, the idea was to turn Doctor Who into much more of a James Bondian, Earthbound set story, with the Doctor permanently stranded on Earth and working in tandem with a military organization to protect the Earth from alien invasion. Obviously, that came to pass the next season with Jon Pertwee, and we'll get there in a couple of weeks. But for now, it's worth noting that the driving reason for this format change was the cost of the series. Yes, the joke is that Doctor Who looks like it was made with the cost of a couple of bubblegum wrappers and some baling wire. But the fact remains that a science fiction show that changes location every week gets terribly expensive very quickly. And so the notion was, if the Doctor was permanently Earthbound, there could be standing sets, recurring characters, recurring costumes, and it would really, really bring down the show's budget and bring it in line with expectations. The irony, then, is that The Invasion wound up being the most expensive Doctor Who story ever broadcast at the time. And it held that title for a couple of years. But even so, the strength of the story sold the idea, and so the die was cast, and the end of the current version of Doctor Who is coming very, very rapidly. Now, I've got two more days of this story, and I've got a couple other notable firsts to talk about tomorrow. But until then, as I always say, stay home, stay safe, be kind, be patient, and I will see you tomorrow.